I see. Now he's not stupid. He didn't just walk in there and think everything's gonna be okay. Now he sees the signs. He gets ready. And like in every other horror movie.
Where is the bookseller?
Probably in the back. Tied up. Cut up. Probably the Shambler.
Freud's The Interpretation of Dreams. It's the work that laid the foundations of psychoanalysis at the beginning of this century.
What else I got here? Just a bunch of anatomy drawings. What else? Anything on the shelf? No. This shelf? Nope.
An old diary.
The pastor declared himself to be the prophet. He renounced God and worshiped a strange pagan entity with a monstrous appearance. His wife tried to reason with her husband, but in vain. He was convinced that he must listen to this voice in his head because it holds the truth. I think the game looks a bit buggy right now. Mystery of Darkwater, Volume 2. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, it's not important. Human skull. Hello. Oh, cool. It's a little air machine. There's gotta be something else around here before we actually have to go back.
The Book of Zion is the foundational work behind Helena Blavatsky's theosophical movement. Its followers place truth on the same footing as a religion.
I like how we're just walking around, just stealing books. I mean, yeah, they're important, but I mean, come on, he's just stealing books. Of course. It's just... Did I read it last time? I think I did.
What does this strange book contain? This book contains unholy knowledge.
This collection catalogs and classifies creatures that I have never heard of. Divinities from the stars. Creatures capable of traveling from one dimension to another. Maybe the paintings are a portal. Let's see. It presents itself as a reference work on the bestiary of the myth. Without giving detail on the mythology to which it refers, its pages are covered with something illustrations. I didn't want to try to butcher that one word. Ooh! Sick ass lava lamp, my guy. Crap baskets. Alright, screw that. I'm going to the other room.
What happened here?
Alright, well, looks like it's regardless.
Let's start over. Where did they break in from? Blood. Seems like amateur work.
Yeah, this prince is no pro. And don't on the floor.
Someone tall left this footprint. A man, probably.
Oh, man. it's too bad it was in old times. You just get a sample of that blood, get a name. Case is closed within, what, a couple hours? Oh, here we go.
No sign of struggle. If the burglar smashed this jar, it wasn't intentionally. Was he hurt then?
Maybe this bookkeeper. Bookkeeper? Maybe the bookstore owner is tougher than he looks. Alright, what about in the other room first? I just really want to avoid that pain. Okay, fine, whatever.
What sort of thief leaves his tools at the crime scene?
Oh, it's a crowbar. I thought that was a cane. Crouch.
What killed all these animals?
What are those? Those cockroaches? Cockroaches and rats. What else?
Nope, what happened that made the burglar flee before finishing his work?
So he's part of the cult. He wanted something.
What the... Charles Hawkins?
Okay, now this is trippy. How is he able to see this? Is it because he just touched it and then that's what, you know, he's able to see?
Looks like the symbol rejected Hawkins. Where did I see it? What sort of power did Sarah Hawkins' painting possess?
Super tricky.
Sarah Hawkins helped hide something in this safe.
That's a good rejecting us too. Let's see. Is there anything else? Come on. Okay, I love the glitch effect, but you know, his investigation mode is always just happening in his head, but this is something. Oh, here it is.
Drake put in a great deal of effort to hide whatever is in here. Everything is linked to the Sarah Hawkins case.
All right, that was pretty cool. I love the whole glitch effect thing. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was all just in his head though. Except maybe the whole falling down thing, that probably was real.
Drake left instructions on how to find the combination of his safe.
Alright, if someone finds these memories, there will be no doubt that I am in serious trouble. My last and only hope is that my body and bones are still in the plane of reality in order that they can be recovered and burned. The funeral urn must be given to my dear mother if she is still of this world. Okay. Whoever reads these lines and demonstrates acuity as sharp as mine can hope to gain access to my most precious possession. It lies within my safe, and the clues to the combination are to be found in three cylinders, each hidden where life, the study combined in the Greek worlds. Wait. Yeah. Each cylinder is numbered, even if... Okay, hang on a second. Even if this is the celebrated other say... Order is the pleasure of the reasoning, but disorder is the light of the imagination. Indeed, despite my preference for organized chaos, I must admit that reason usually prevails in the end. How long is this? Okay. If by chance a person, or should I say genius, why thank you, would smash my intelligence and find the combination of the safe, I would ask that they deliver its contents to the safekeepings of my friend and colleague, Professor Armitage of Miskatonic University. The content of this safe is not only a vast digestive knowledge, but also a weapon that is far too dangerous for it to fall into the wrong hands. I hope that you'll be able to appreciate the danger that this represents, and that you will act accordingly. In any event, I will neither be there to guide you, nor to suffer from your actions. Okay. I need to get better at reading. Okay. What else we got in here? Another book. Sweet. Nothing.
Is everyone on this island taking sleeping pills?
Probably. I don't probably have any nightmares.
What link did he find between Charles Hawkins and an old amulet?
Okay, is he actually telling me to find it? Alright, he said we're Greek. So it has to be something involving. Okay, so it's gonna be in a book, basically.
Arkham editions. Never heard of him.
The book is supposedly written by blah blah blah. Oh, you know
what?
How
many volumes are there in this collection?
Okay, I think I get it. It's gonna be so
another
the combination.
Volume by Arkham editions.
Yeah, so the combination is going to be the correct volume numbers that involve the hidden clue that he mentioned, so...
Arkham editions. How many volumes are there in this? Another volume by Arkham editions. Arkham editions. Never heard of him.
Okay. I think that was the last... I thought that was the last book. Okay. Jesus Christ.
Rumors that Drake tried to hide. I should perhaps listen to them.
Okay. Well then, so much for it being in the books. No, it was just behind the freaking anatomy drawing. Great hiding spot. Not. I would have hidden them in a big book. And I'm hard to find. So I thought I was being really smart, thinking like, oh, of course, it's gotta be the books. Nope, not even close. Oh, perfect. Gramophone. Book. Chalice?
A kind of chalice.
This goblet seems to be very ancient. It seems to be made of gold and decorated with real precious stones. Do the rubies and sapphires make up a specific motive? Ah, crap. Is it gonna be a color thing? No, I can't turn anymore. I can't take it either. Okay.
Things are not looking good.
I would know. I don't play chess. Okay, now we're going phones.
And these red drops. Like precious stones lie fixed, set in divine gold. To be the guardian of the Grail does not protect me from its attractions, Henry. And I do confess it. I am willing to pay to know its secrets. I finally understood that we were only pieces on the chessboard of the gods. Let those of us who are still standing protect our White Queen from their dark soldiers. I see our number dwindling. And my will strengthens as my apprehension grows. We shall refuse to be the playthings of destiny.
Okay, so he's talking about the chessboard.
Dear friend, I thank you again for the anthology of the works of Arkham editions that you sent me. Volume 9, Azathoth and Other Horrors, seemed particularly relevant to my research. I never tire of browsing through them.
Okay, so I'm gonna have to re-listen now, so... This one's the clues within the chessboard. This one's within the volume 9. This one.
Red drops, like precious stones, lie fixed, set in divine gold.
Okay, it's
the
chalice.
To be the guardian of the Grail does not protect me from its attractions, Henry. And I do confess it. I am willing to pay to know its secrets.
Okay, so I'm guessing it's however many red stones
the
there are.
The chalice of knowledge.
Okay, so one, two, crap, how am I supposed to keep count? Okay, this position, one, two, three, four, five. Five redstones on the chalice. Alright, let's go to volume 9 real quick.
What did Drake say about this collection? So these are the volumes that Drake was talking about in his message.
Okay, it's this one. I don't know why I'm dumb. This one's 9, I think. A collection of poems by Edward Pigman Derby, also known as the Nightmare Lyrics. This collection of poems was sensationally received when first published in 1908. Derby was only 18 years old. This volume is part of the Arkham Anthology, so I'm guessing the number is 18. So we said
the Chalice five, right? Of Knowledge.
One, two, three, four, five. So five redstones, 18, and or 1908, and then
the Queen has little protection.
Damn it, I don't know the chess positions. So the chess positions are how many are surrounding the Queen?
I finally understood that we were only pieces on the chessboard of the gods. Let those of us who are still standing protect our White Queen from their dark soldiers. I see our number dwindling, and my will strengthens as my apprehension grows. We shall refuse to be the playthings of destiny.
Okay, so it might be... Damn, that doesn't help either. Alright. How many are protecting the Queen from the knights? So, there's three surrounding her, with two more underneath her, and one dark knight right next to her. Can get to five. Maybe. It's either however many number of pawns there are, or it has to be the chess position of the Queen, because there are numbers in this. I know it's like A2 or something like that, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, hopefully it's that. Okay, so it only goes up to 10. Alright, it only goes up to 9, so... I said 5. Okay, 5. So if it wasn't... Try 9, and then, damn it, let's try 9 again. If not, I'm gonna try either 5 or 3. Okay, there! That wasn't that difficult. Yo, back away from the book, man. Back away from the book. You know what? Pull out that dagger. Stab the book. Stab the book. Stab the book!